You're an active member of the Players Coalition, correct? On the board member in the task force?
Yes, sir.
So what are your thoughts on Jay-Z and teaming up in the NFL in the manner in which he did and the conversation surrounding it? Your former teammate Eric Reed has been very vocal on this subject as well. I give you the floor to try and give me the state of what is going on from the Players Coalition.
Yeah, well, I think the first thing to acknowledge is that what the NFL and Jay-Z did has absolutely nothing to do with the Players Coalition. I mean, we weren't aware. We didn't know any of that. So, and the Players Coalition is just a way that the guys got together to try to figure out a way to work together to help beyond just protesting. And that's why it was formed, and the guys are able to give grants to different charities and other folks who are really doing the work on the ground, doing the real work. And while I think the Jay-Z and the NFL could possibly lead to some positive things down the line, there's a lot of questions, and there's a lot to question about the way everything initially happened. But the one thing I do know is that it's clearly a business deal in terms of, in regards to music and those things. But when you have someone like Jay-Z, he has the power to influence. And not only has he, you know, can he talk about it, but he's lived it. He's lived it. He's been able to talk about these injustices that everyone's protesting about or talking about. He's lived these things. So I don't think you can ever question that piece of it. But obviously it was a business deal. I think if it would have came out like, yes, this is a business deal, and after that, you know, we're going to try to figure out ways to work on things. So you can't rub it all into one because it's not the same thing. And I don't view it that way.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's important to acknowledge that. But, I mean, I don't know. I'm watching just like everyone else. And I hope that, you know, something good comes out of it. And I know Jay-Z has that influence. And a guy like Meek Mill, who's one of the artists who's going to be featured, that I read. I mean, Meek Mill lived everything that people are protesting about from top to bottom, he's lived it all. So to question someone like Meek Mill or to question someone like Jay-Z is hard. But, you know, I get it. It seems very, you know, the way things came about, it wasn't the prettiest picture for anyone to see.
So what would you like to see done on the social justice front for between players, owners, and the league? What maneuver would you, Torrey Smith, like to see employed here? For the benefit.
Well, I wish they employed Colin Kaepernick. You know, I think sometimes it's like a black eye to speak on issues or want to support and really change issues when there's a guy out there who has the ability to play, but people don't want to deal with the negative press or the fan reaction that may come from hiring a player that can help your team in terms of talent. So that would be first things first. But to me, I don't view the NFL as the savior of these issues. I believe the NFL has the ability and the platform to educate people, the ability and the money to help those grassroots organizations who are helping people directly, and the ability to influence others to try to do more in their community. That's the value that I see there. But I think it's always going to be hard to talk about the positive things that the NFL is doing. And I'm telling you this, and I'm a guy that if the NFL is doing something positive, I would love to support it, because I'm all for helping other people. But I think no matter how long we go about this, it's always going to be hard to not have some type of stain when, you know, a guy like Colin Kaepernick doesn't even get a chance to have a workout.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.